Hi, I'm going to show you how to do calculations using a spreadsheet. So let's say that I have this data here with electric potential difference in volts and current in milliamps, and I want to calculate the power. Don't worry about if you don't understand what those terms mean. It's just the ideas that I'll show you how to do calculations. So to calculate the power, I would need to take the electric potential difference times the current, and I've got a large data set, so I want to program a formula as opposed to just grinding it out on my calculator. So what I'll do here is I'll label the column. So it'll be the power in milliwatts if I multiply these two numbers. So I'm going to say equals, instead of writing 0.97, I type in the cell number A2, and then I'm going to multiply that by C2. And I'll hit enter, and there it is. And so then I just, so now the magic of the spreadsheet is that I can grab this corner here in that box and pull down, and now I have all of the numbers calculated. Now you might notice that a lot of these numbers are ending at seemingly random numbers past the decimal. Looks kind of bad. So you can control that with this by increasing or decreasing the number of decimals. Don't worry about significant digits, just blaze ahead, but make it look nice. The other part of this is that you can determine the plus or minus in the calculated value based on the plus or minus in the data that's used to generate that calculated value. So look in your general lab instructions and you'll see formulas. So I'm going to enter the multiplication formula. It's a little bit complicated, but I just type in the equals sign to tell the spreadsheet that I'm entering a formula. And then it equals the result of the calculation, which in this case is cell E2, times the square root of the sum of the squares of the fractional uncertainties. So it would be B2 over A2 squared, the uncertainty in the electric potential difference, and then it would be plus D2 over C2 squared, taking into account the uncertainty in the current. And I hit enter, and there's my uncertainty. So I'll go ahead and copy that down. There it is. So all at once, I've done 10 or 12 different calculations. And then again, I can adjust this. You want to make sure that the last digit of the power matches the last digit of its uncertainty. That's just a number writing convention. It's not a law of physics. So I'd reduce it until I'm down to the hundredth, like I did with power. Okay, so there you have it. That's how you do multiple calculations in a spreadsheet, and one example of how to propagate the uncertainty in a calculation.